everyone's gotten a drink. I'm gonna let Robert start off with SSL and WordPress. Robert is also the co-organizer of our meetup.
Yeah, okay. Yay. Hi. How many of you know SSL? No? Okay, so it's half-half. Alright, because I actually prepared a lot of front slide to introduce what SSL is and stuff. So a bit of myself first, I'm Robert. So I'm a WordPress developer slash user. Currently also interested in performance optimizations and deployment of servers. And at the same time also doing analytics. Currently I'm a digital analytics digital analyst with attribute data. My boss is sitting right in front of me. Yeah, so
which one?
Boss, colleague.
colleague.
Yeah. And then so what we do is more on implementing Adobe marketing cloud solutions and also a bit of Google Analytics as well. Okay, so what I'm going to cover through is what is SSL, why is it important to secure your site with SSL, and where can you get it from? And last part is implementation. There are two different kinds of general implementation steps. One is shared hosting. The other one is dedicated of VPS based hosting. So I will give you a demonstration if possible for the dedicated part. But it might fail because I forgot to take account of the system's requirements. Okay, so. Oops. Alright, so what is SSL cert? So this is taken off Wikipedia, I think. It's a digital certificate that certifies ownership of public key by a name, subject of a certificate, blah blah blah. But in short, it's basically that you see facebook.com, you see HTTPS. Basically, it stands for HTTP over SSL. So what it actually does is to do this, where it creates a secure communication through these steps between you and the server, so that there's no information leak between your browser and the server. So that is actually the importance of SSL, securing the communication channel. Why is it important? Is because you might have personal data going through the website, like Facebook. You're going to put in your personal information. There are also sections in Facebook where you can put in your payment information, your credit card details. It applies almost to any e-commerce site, any site that deals with personal data, like government website as well. So what happens is that without the SSL certification, the certificate, the communication channel is unsecured, and you are prone to this thing called man-in-the-middle attack, where a privileged network administrator does not need to be an ISP, does not need to be Singtel or MyPublic. It can be a Wi-Fi admin to hijack the connection, and then listen to what you put, whatever information that you give to the website. So the importance of SSL is a SEO boost. This is implemented by Google since 2014. So for Google, they actually index their websites, the internet with the content and a lot of other arbitrary ranking signals. HTTPS is one of the arbitrary ranking signals. It used to constitute less than 1% of the overall SEO ranking score. But since 2014, it has bumped me up to at least 1%, I think. Can't remember the exact figure. We have a SEO expert sitting right in the corner. Yeah, so anyway, what happened is that when they did the switch over for this importance, this ranking signal, what happened was that a lot of websites, even arbitrary websites like online publications like Mothership.sg and stuff like that, they basically just secure their website with SSL, and they actually receive a jump in the page ranking that they have from Google. over competitors who do not have. So there are a lot. This is just one way that you can actually get a quick boost in your SEO's ranking. So where can you get these certs? The first one is by self-signing a cert. The second one is to obtain from a certificate authority. However, I do not recommend you to do self-signing, even though that it is free. It's because you will see this tiny red little box here in Google Chrome to say that the site security certificate is not trusted. So in order to have it be trusted, you have to be trusted by a certificate authority, and that is not free. And another thing is that it's a bit technical, but there's a quick tutorial by Heroku on how to generate SSL certificate by yourself if you are interested in it. One main use for self-signed cert most probably is because you want to do a quick test on your development site locally. That's when you can use a self-signed cert because you are not going to expose that environment anyway to the public. The second way is through certificate authority. The first way, the primary way is the only way is to pay for it. The second way is to have it now free. So the paid version, the paid certs are actually issued by these certificate authorities like Komodo, Symantec, GoDaddy, Starcom. You might see their certs logo displayed on e-commerce site. So all these are actually not cheap. You will see on GoDaddy, the most basic is $91.99 per year. So for a small site or a budding a startup, it's a cost that you might want to just invest in. But if you're really really very bootstrapping, $91 for a year is I would say expensive. And you only protect one site, which means to say that if your domain is example.com and you have a subdomain called maybe store.example.com, you will have to get a second cert, or you get a multiple cert, which is like $100 or $200. The second one is actually Let's Encrypt. So Let's Encrypt is free. The reason why it's free is because they want to make the web more secure. The cost that you see, the price, why is it free, is also because it's also backed by corporate sponsors. And currently it's on public beta, and right now it's actually as secure as paid certificate authorities. So the only thing is that you have to go through command line to generate these certs. But as I say, it's free. So for shared hosting, one downside is that Let's Encrypt certs are not likely to be supported by companies like GoDaddy or Bluehost. Why is it so? It's because there are existing tie-ins with other certificate authorities, or like GoDaddy, they run their own certificate authority. So it's basically a golden goose, like they do not want to chop it off. And the third one is that the integration with a shared hosting management software is rudimentary. So like cPanel, which is cPanel and Plex, both of which are actually the most popular shared hosting management software that most of the companies like GoDaddy use. For cPanel, it's an unofficial plugin, which means it's not supported by cPanel, and it's also not free. It's about $30 a year. Plex has an official plugin under active development by their development team. However, as of now, it is still considered much rough in the works, and not a lot of companies actually putting it in. Most of Plex users who are putting Let's Encrypt in are the small time companies, or basically having their own shared hosting environment. The general steps is just basically one step, which is to follow the instructions as provided by your shared hosting providers on acquiring the cert. Generally, on upon purchasing of the cert, the server will be automatically updated to have port 443, which is the HTTPS port open for the cert, with the cert installed already. You just need to do basic configurations like enable redirecting from HTTP to HTTPS in your .htss config if or virtual host if you're using Apache, or modifying your Nginx rewrite rules. For dedicated hosting, you are free to use any certs, purely because you have full control over your server. So the tutorials are actually nicely written by DigitalOcean. DigitalOcean is a VPS hosting provider, and it has a very strong community, user community, and they write a lot of tutorials. If you are not a user of DigitalOcean, you are free to use their tutorials. So basically, these are just the steps to start off with. You clone Let's Encrypt repository in your server. Then you stop your service, your web server, and then you start the entire process. So what I'm going to show it's a bit dark. All right. So if you can see? No. All right, never mind. Then in this case, I'll just continue with screenshots lah. So what happens is that too dark lah, so cannot. It's not nice. And so what happens is that you just land onto this screen, this very blue screen, like Windows 95 like that. The first thing I ask you is your email address. So you put your email address. The second thing that they will ask you is to read the terms and conditions. But who here actually read the TOS? No, right? So you just go to the next screen. Then after that, you just enter the domain. The domain names that you want. So in this case, it's my personal domain. So it's like robertsky.com or www.robertsky.com. And after everything is done, it takes a while for it to process the certs, because it's after all a cryptographically generated cert. It will come out with this important note. So it says that if you lose your account credentials, you can recover through the email that you have input. So if you put like test@test.com and you lose your cert, GG, good luck with you guys. Then a second one is that they will say the certificate and the chain have been saved at this location. It will expire at this date. The expiry is 90 days. It's short-lived cert, so you actually have to renew the cert every 90 days. Then credentials, everything, blah blah blah. And a very nice message will say, please support our work at their website, letsencrypt.org/donate. And after that, what you do is basically update your Nginx configuration, like what I showed before. There we go. Yes. So basically, just update with this. My server that did demonstration is Nginx, but Apache is also similar. So just use, if you have control over your own host, your own server, use the vhost option rather than HTSS. That's the recommended option. HTSS is more for people who are on shared hosting, because the shared hosting providers usually will not give access to virtual host files because it's generally more powerful than HTSS. And you basically redefine some constants like your WP home, WP site URL to have this HTTPS, I have underlined it here, right? Put these constants in your wp-config.php file. And then after that, to set up auto-renewal, basically after this you're done, you just need to restart your web server. Then you can just do an auto-renewal. Auto-renewal, you basically just put in this chunk of location block in
for Nginx, put this chunk of location block in the SSL block, and then create a Let's Encrypt config file. I'll show you where to get to find that this kind of resources, and then you set up a cron job to renew a cert if it's left with less than 30 days. So basically, that's it. Oh. Yep, that's it. So basically, to show you my very twee site, if you go to the connection, it's actually verified by Let's Encrypt Authority, and you can look at the certificate information. Yeah, so it's valid until April, but it'll be updated sometime in March lah. Yeah. To get the resources for Let's Encrypt, you can just basically go to their website, and they have a very strong community support, forums, documentation, and I have to say that it is really rough in the works. It's you say it's free, automated, and open, but it's not here, it's in public beta, so there are things that will break. In a span of 1 month, I actually implemented this Let's Encrypt cert for Hackerspace website as well. In a span, I did that last month. In the span of this 1 month, there were a lot of changes in the tools that they have built that I didn't know of until another member told me about it. So this is actually the forums where you can actually ask for help if you want to. Documentation over here. You can just go to Quick Start Guide, and you just walk through the steps.
Oh yes, one thing for
Apache is that Apache is easier to renew. You don't need to put in that not well known directive into the virtual host, because at the moment they have created a rudimentary plugin for renewing for Apache web servers. So basically it's just Let's Encrypt dash auto, cert only dash Apache, and just do a renewal. Yeah. So Nginx support will come much later, around March. Yeah. So basically that's it. Yeah. So basically this entire site right now you can see is actually fully secured. If you look at the console, I have a 404, but never mind. Yeah, so if you look at the console, there's no errors. Some of the sites may give you some errors, like just to show you this site, is that you get this warning called mixed content. It's usually due to linking of content. For this one, it's a linking of to a third-party website that you do not have control, or this site owner doesn't have control over. So it gives this kind of mixed content warning, and instead of that green bar, the green logo that you see, the green lock logo, is basically the blank web page, like you see for the normal HTTP stuff. Yeah. Oh yes, one more thing about shared hosting is that sometimes they'll give you cache, like Vanish cache. So for Bluehost, they actually give you a Vanish cache, and they call the entire package as optimized WordPress hosting. But what it does is, but the thing is that it does not do the configuration for HTTPS perfectly, and you will have to tap on the header called http://proto_address. Difficult to remember, but there's actually thing called insecure.
Sorry, but I thought Vanish doesn't support SSL.
It doesn't support. That's the thing. Right. So, but you can actually use a header to I don't deal with Varnish myself exactly. So I do not know about it until someone actually asked me to help him with this his site. You can actually just use this
plugin called Insecure Content Fixer.
So what it has, it's basically, I don't think they have screenshots. Yeah, they don't have screenshots for the for this. So what it gives you is that panel, admin panel, with the option to detect your SSL configuration in some manner. Yeah. Think that's about all I have. Any questions?
Robert, perhaps a basic question.
So yeah.
In what scenario would you have to revoke and change your cert?
In a scenario where your cert is compromised, meaning to say that someone managed to access your server, take the cert, and then use the cert to do a man-in-the-middle attack, or basically compromise communication channel.
So the person steal your key and...
Yes. Okay. Basically, what the cert what I have is two keys. One is the public key where it's on your browser. The other one is the private key which is on your server. As long as the private key is not compromised, you are safe. If it's compromised, good luck to you. Another one is if the upstream authority is compromised, like say let's encrypt. If it is compromised, you have to revoke your server, your key, because basically they can use that compromised authority file to regenerate and basically do the same thing, hijack your communication channels. So for Let's Encrypt, they actually show very nicely of how it's done. Like blah 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 in okay. Technical review certificates. So right now the certs are signed under root X1. This X1. In the event that X1 is compromised, they will switch to X2. And all these certs here, service certificates, will be invalidated automatically by them. And you have to revalidate. Yeah. So that is a standing by. This is the structure that they have. Yeah. So one thing about certificate authorities, why certificate authorities want to charge you is because they say they need to cover costs for auditing of their organization. That is something that they keep repeating. And to spice up the offering is that they give like insurance, sort of like insurance coverage of up to X amount, minimum 10K or 100K. But to be frank, this kind of stuff, I don't think needs insurance. It's basically just giving them some, basically it's just them telling you to pay out for the money for something that something intangible. But what Let's Encrypt does is that instead of getting the end users to pay, they're getting corporate sponsors. So these corporate sponsors are not small time corporate sponsors. They have a whole list of sponsors here. It's not small, like Mozilla, the people behind Firefox. Facebook is on it. Automatic is a company behind WordPress, Shopify. Yes, there are also other familiar names like SiteGround. So they are behind this because they want the internet to be more secure. Purely for that. Yeah.
Thanks. Okay, Robert, is it best practice to use CloudFront, AWS CloudFront, right, to load the SSL rather than just load through APIs like
that? That I would say depends on your on what you want to do. Because if you have a lot of a lot of traffic, CloudFront might be able to help you with distributing the resources. Whereas for me, because I'm using a small, my site is small, number of visitors per day, 40. So just doing it simple, I'm keeping it simple. I just use it on VPS. But if you have to, just go through, you can go through CloudFront.
So let's Encrypt is also compatible with CloudFront?
That is a good question. I'm not really sure. If CloudFront allows you to load your own cert, basically if any any companies allow you to use your own cert, you can use Let's Encrypt. Yeah. Even if you cannot generate it on your own server, you cannot generate on CloudFront, you might be able to generate on server and pass the key on. Yeah. Any more questions? If not, I can pass my time on to Hasru.